most valuable resource on Earth, time.
Greetings. Well, this is going to be a complicated one. I've produced this vlog today to chuck my threepence worth in on the contretemps over the MOONSWATCH that was released 5 to 6 weeks ago. I've already done a video on it, a short one, The Impossible Dream. This is on a different theme. Okay, the big question that's arisen of late is it an Omega or is it a Swatch? Now, I'd like to look at this and encompass a wide-ranging opinion, and this is my humble and honest opinion and a personal one with the help of my lovely wife. As you can see with the timepieces involved, they have the Omega logo on the face, or Omega I should say. Some say Omega, some say Omega. They also have the wording Swatch, Omega times Swatch. They've produced a number of beautiful variants and colors, all linked to the planets. Now, Omega very much has thrown a lifeline and given the opportunity for many to join the gang and be able to play in the playground. A similar remark I said about the Bullover Lunar Pilot, and this is because of the price. Swatch have gone to a great length and deal in making the molds and develop the design technology to accommodate the fitting tribute in what is essentially a quartz watch. There are advantages on both sides, in the Omega camp and the Swatch camp. And with Swatch, obviously, it's, and their fans, it's related to the price. And with Omega, they will know that one day they have got generations of people that have come on board and have wanted to buy the Speedmaster and have cut their teeth on this very, very keenly priced MOONSWATCH. Obviously, the negatives to the MOONSWATCH is it's not a Speedmaster, and it's had a few problems of late with the introduction in the marketing and some issues to do with the case against the skin of the wearer. Amiga will benefit in the long run as they may come up with a number of alternatives in their range in relation to the Speedmaster, and it will give them a lot of ideas for changes within the development of what is quintessentially the best chronograph on sale in horology today. Well, the debate on the issue is a relatively simple one to fathom out to anybody with a modicum of, let's say, cordiality and agreement. There has to be only one way that you can look at it, and that is as positive as possible. The Amiga Speedmaster is considered the best all-round chronograph available on the market, and so it should be. And MoonSwatch is a great starter watch for many people, including the youngsters that want to start out in horology like I did when I was 7 to 8 years old. The logical conclusion to all of this is that not only is it an Omega and a Swatch, it really should be treated as a combination of both. It neither can be called just an Omega and in the same breath just a Swatch watch. And I'm sure that all of us that want to embrace this positive move forward should react and realize and understand that it is both an Omega and a Swatch. Hence Omega MoonSwatch is my outcome of the debate. I hope we can all go forward together and enjoy this wonderful initiative. As I said, it's a golden opportunity for us all to get together and enjoy something that's been placed before us. Whether you're young, old, starting out, or whether you've been in horology for some time, this is a great coming together that's been afforded to us by Omega and Swatch. I look back on the years when I was a kid starting out at the age of 7 to 8 years old, and I'd have been thrilled and overjoyed to be given a watch like this. Even though at $200 to $250, still quite an expensive piece, but it's an opportunity for us to gain an understanding that the MoonSwatch is an Omega and a Swatch together. Whatever your hopes or belief, may it go with you, and do take care. Thank you.
The most valuable resource on Earth, time. The most valuable resource on Earth, time.
Run like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning on an ever spinning reel. Like a snowball down a mountain, or a carnival balloon. Like a carousel that's turning, running rings around the moon. Like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minute.